Deontay Wilder finally gets his chance to fight for the world title. He's the number one ranked contender. He's won all his bouts by knockout, and he's probably the most exciting American heavyweight fighter in the last 20 years. So it brings me a great pleasure to introduce to you the new champion come January 17th. Deontay Wilder, say a few words. Deontay, can you introduce yourself?
No, just no better in the dashing than in that. You know what I mean? How y'all guys doing today? I'm excited about the fight. I'm excited to be viewing my talent again on Showtime and definitely with Golden Boy once more on my range of becoming the next heavyweight champion of the world. You know, I have no doubt at the end of this fight, my hand will be raised and then words will come out to announce the mouth and the new heavyweight champ of the world. I have no doubt. I've been waiting on this for a very, very long time, and hard work is nothing that I'm not used to. I've been working all my life, you know, so nothing ever been given to me in my life. I don't expect this title to be given to me. I want to earn it. So I'm glad that he's at full health, because I don't want no excuses for my victories. I've been giving all excuses for my victories, all excuses for my 32 knockouts. So when I gain 33, I don't want to hear no whispers. I don't want to hear no excuses from nobody. I earned everything I've got thus far, and I'm definitely going to earn the belt. You know, it's going to be a great fight. This is one I've been looking forward to for a very long time. And, you know, I commend on Bermane on winning the title and becoming the first Haitian to be a heavyweight champion for his country. You know, like I said before, I'm all about history. But it's my time. It's my time to make history. America been yearning for American heavyweight for a very long time, and that's my part. This is where I come in at and give them their world champion. So here I am. I have arrived, and I'm here to stay for a very long time.
Hey, Steve, hold on. Since he said that, let me put this into place. I want to introduce this young man named Bermane Stiverne. He's a guy that worked very, very hard. He went through the struggles, had to go to a year and a half layoff because he couldn't fight nobody because the Klitschko's were finding all type of excuse not to fight in Vitaly. And then he ended up being a politician going into Ukraine to try to be president and end up being the mayor. So all this time, you know, we had to hold Bermane back, and he was ready to fight. He's a dynamic fighter. He's a guy that's going to be champion for quite a long time, and he's going to be there. And I have to applaud Steven Espinoza and Les Moonves for his ingenious appointment of Steven to be able to capture this imagination and then put it on Showtime for the world to see when this guy named Bermane Stiverne champion. You know, he was champion from in absentia by not being able to fight for the title, and then he beats Areola twice. He had to go through that twice, two times. And so we're going to add to that a guy named Deontay Wilder. And so right now, let me introduce, with no further ado, the heavyweight champion of the world, Bermane Stiverne. Listen quietly and open your eyes and see. This is history on the making. Bermane, tell it to him like it is.
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Hey, champ.
How you doing?
I'm all right.
Yeah.
What's Sophia at?
Bermane, your thoughts on the defending your championship?
Listen, this is... well, you know, I'm not gonna be on the phone too long. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a entertainer or promoter like my opponent is. But what I will say is, from the first time I moved to Vegas, I always wanted to fight for the title. You know, that didn't happen. So now I'm fighting. I'm defending my title in Vegas at the MGM. And that's another dream that came through. I'm prepared. I've been ready. You know what I'm saying? Like I said before, ain't nobody gonna beat me. This belt ain't going nowhere. And that's about it. I mean, you know, I could sitting on the phone and tell you this and that. I'd rather show you on January 17th. January 17th is going to be a short night. It's going to be painful, really painful.
Introduce your manager, Camille Estefan. Camille, words from you, please.
Thank you, Steve. Pleasure being here. Looking forward to a great date on January 17th on Showtime. I want to comment a little bit about the fight. You know, Wilder with 32-0, 32 knockouts. I'm going to tell you what I really believe. I don't like to play things politically correctly. You know, 32-0, 32 knockouts against who? Firstly, we believe this is a choreographed career, very, very well done. Good job. But I believe Wilder will quickly realize that fighting at this level is a whole different universe. By then, it will be too late for him. Beware will make a statement. I'm positive of this. This is what I know. And all this talk has no place in the ring. We'll see what happens in the ring. Don't blink, guys. I really hope all the fans on this planet will get to realize who the new Mike Tyson is. And that guy's name is Bermane Beware Stiverne. We earned this. We paid our dues. We waited a long time. We've been dodged for many years and blocked for many years. And time has come for people to realize that the most beautiful talent in boxing today is called Bermane Stiverne. We'll show you on January 17th.
This question is for Mr. Wilder. Camille, very direct, very candid and direct, says that he believes that your career to this point has been choreographed. I'm wondering your response to that, please.
Well, you know, the things I do, I make the eye don't believe. You know, the mind definitely plays tricks on you. And, you know, on the outside of the ring, you see one thing, but on the inside of the ring, it's a whole nother different thing. It's almost like a magic trick that, you know, it's unbelievable that how in the world did it happen like that. But just like he said, on January 17th, we will find out. And we'll see what have been choreographed for sure. They go off of one opponent. They go off of beating a Chris Areola, a brawler. You know, they go off of being him and saying they paid, they do. But guess what? I got one man on my resume that will kill Bermane's whole record, whole opponents on the career. He go by the name of Malik Scott. He will beat him hands down, and I'm willing to put my purse on it. He will beat every opponent that he has on his record. And that's just one opponent. But, you know, everybody can believe what they want, but when it comes to that time, the night of that fight, the truth will reveal itself. And I'm super confident in what I can do. You know, I'm super confident, and I can't wait, man. This is exciting for me. I cannot wait.
I'm very excited
somebody's going to lose their job. I'm going to put his whole team out of commission. That's my promise.
Excellent answer. I appreciate it. I would be remiss if I didn't ask the inimitable Don King a question. Don, do you believe that Wilder is experienced enough to maybe win this fight, or do you believe he doesn't have the necessary experience to hang with Stiverne?
Well, I think that Wilder's a great fighter. You know, he's also a great talker, and he's a guy that's coming there, making his way up the ladder to be heavyweight champion of the world. And I feel that Bermane will give him the next lesson, you know, how to do at a later date, you know, after he meets Bermane in this heavyweight championship fight, the fight for peace here at the MGM Grand. And I think that Richard Sturm and everybody there will be very excited, you know what I mean? That's the president of entertainment there. It will be entertaining. And it will be entertaining. And rest assured that Bermane, beware, and that's what they say, beware, that he will be still standing. But I love Deontay Wilder.
Hey, Bermane, are you there?
Yes.
You know, you are a guy with most of your victories by knockout. You know, you've made a lot of short fights, but you've also been the distance. But Deontay, one of the questions that many people have about him, they don't debate or downplay his punching power, but he has never been past four rounds because he's been knocking his opponents out. Is part of your thought process in this fight to try to get him into the later rounds where he never has been, and perhaps that lack of experience will be good for you and not so good for him?
First of all, whoever he fought or the level of opposition he had, I don't care about that. And that's not how we based on, we didn't base our training camp like he fought nobody. I train like I'm fighting the best out there. And, You know, if he didn't go more than four rounds, that's not my business. That's his business. But all I got to say is January 17, we everybody that had questions about this man, we get the answers. And more than an answer. You know what I'm saying? So listen, oh my God. Not for 1 second. And I don't even care if you went 24 rounds or whatever it is. It don't even matter. It don't matter. Like, it really don't matter. All I'm saying is I just can't wait. I'm just getting ready to be unleashed January 17. That's all I'm waiting on.
In the meantime, we just stay
quiet and we keep working. That's all we're doing.
I'm a different fighter. You know, my name's Deontay Wilder. I'm not another boxer that you have encountered in. You know, I know my skills. I know my abilities. You know, my thing is the hard work is done in the gym. I've been doing it ever since day one. I started boxing. Nothing has ever been given to me, man. You listening to a man that nothing. A lot of promises have been made, but nothing has been fulfilled for me. So I don't know the easy road, man. I don't know what it is to have it or be given to me. Everything I've had ever since I was a kid on up to adult age, I had to work for it. So I don't know what the easy part is. So going past four rounds, that's nothing. That's 12 rounds is an appetizer for me to a full course meal. That's nothing for me. So there's nothing in the back of my mind that I cannot go past four rounds. You know, when it's time to fight, when the lights, camera, action start, that's the fun part for me, man. So I want to make it easy. I want to make it a short night because guess what? I don't get paid for overtime. So no need for me to stick around for no overtime. But if the fight may go past 12, hey, let it go. We can go back to 15 if y'all want to do it. We can up the price on it. I have no concern, no worry in my mind at all. And I promise you, you know, if it go past 4, then so be. Let's go. May the people get their money worth. If it go lesser than 4, then so be. The people have came to see a great fight. We both want it. This is highly anticipated bout. I can't wait. He can't wait. And the best man going to win of the night. And I already know who the best man is. You know, they talk about all this experience and all it. Really, if you want to break it down, I have the most experience. You know, just because you started boxing doesn't mean you have more experience than me. To gain experience, you have to work. You can't go to a job and say, I have the experience for it and not put in no work. Most heavyweights don't even get in the gym until they got a fight coming up. I'm not the average heavyweight. I go to work like this is my 9-to-5 every day. I don't miss a day. Every day I'm in the gym working on my work, my art and craft, as if I'm finna get ready to fight for world title. You don't believe me? Ask my people. That's right. You don't believe me? Ask my trainer. You know, that's what I do. So that's how you gain the experience, not just because you started before a person. And he definitely don't have the ring experience that I have. And he ain't not even on the biggest space. He don't have the ring experience. I got 32 fights. He only got 26. Who got the most experience? And we already said about the opponent. But then, you know, we can say what we want. I can say all I want. I can sound good and flow with it all at the same time. But January the 17th, I hope I get to answer a lot of questions, man, because a lot of things are going to be revealed. You know, and I can't wait. I'm so passionate about this fight, man. I wish it was tomorrow. I can't wait, man.
Hi, Bermane, first of all, can you talk a little bit about, since you won the belt, how it did change your life? You and I touched on it a few months ago before you went to Haiti and for the summer to visit. How have things been since we talked last?
Nothing but blessing. Nothing but blessing and love. And, you know, it made me appreciate things different, you know what I'm saying, trying to go back and work harder. And I actually get the desire to get to want more. I'm not satisfied with just that one title. You know, I do want to make a lot of defenses. You know, defend my title. You know, that's what makes a champions. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, obviously, all I want is more. It's not enough. I'm loving it and I cherish it. I'm still hungry. I'm still wanna eat. I still want more.
Yeah. What's the best way to beat Wilder, in your opinion, as you formulated the game plan for this fight? You know, you really did a nice job finishing up Chris in L.A. back in May. Could you maybe talk a little bit about what your thoughts are to fight a guy like this?
January 17, don't blink. I can show you better than I can tell you.
You know, we've talked about, you know, some of the things that Emmanuel Stewart has said and you know, what your grandmother has said. But you also have another source of inspiration, and I guess that's your daughter, who was born with spina bifida. Can you talk a little bit about how that has kind of more or less pushed you into boxing and continues to inspire you and what she means to your career?
I mean, she inspires. I mean, we inspire each other each and every day, man. She inspires me a lot still now because when she was 1 year old, I promised her that Daddy would become a world champion, and now I can make this. This can be realistic, you know. I can make this promise reality now, you know, and I will, you know. So, but she's been through so much, you know. She's been through so much throughout her 9 years of living and still going through a lot now, but she's good though. I mean, she's happy. Daddy can support her to beyond her belief, and soon will be more than that. But she knows what's going on, and she a lot of people say they're my number one fan, but I know for sure she's my ultimate number one fan. You know, and she motivates me to keep going because I know as a 9 year old girl. And going through all the things, she didn't go through the surgeries and the doctors and the needles being sticked through her as she's screaming, you know, for her lungs, reaching for her father and make me want to hit the doctors. I know if she can go through that I can go through the trials and tribulations of becoming world champion, you know. All we know is working hard. Throughout my life, my generation, on down the line, you know, all the Wilders, man, I never met a Wilder that wasn't tough, not only in life but outside as well too, you know what I mean? We all strong, man. I got a big family, and we're all strong, man. We don't know what it is to be given nothing, you know, and that's the thing. So, yeah. So it's gonna do me a lot of justice and a lot of pride. I'm gonna be a proud father when it comes that time to come back and show my baby what I brought her because I promised that to her, and I can't let her down, man. I can't let her down. It's just like making God a promise. He's counting on you to do what you said you were going to do, and she's counting on me to do as a father what I said, and I never let my children down. I never let them. If I said I was going to do something, if I was going to be a certain time, if I was going to take them somewhere, no matter how busy my schedule got, I done that for them, you know. So, you know, it's nothing like a love for your children, man, and I love mine dearly, and I got to fulfill that promise. It's nothing against nobody. It's just this is something I've been promised my daughter a long time ago, man. It gotta be fulfilled.
Hey, Deontay.
Yes, sir.
So going back a little bit to you spoke in your earlier remarks about you mentioned the Malik Scott fight, for example, as a big win for you. And I know that was a quick one, obviously. But I'm wondering, do you wish that in your 31 fights that you've had so far, or 32 fights rather, all knockouts, that somewhere along the line that you would have had a fight with a fighter that was considered by the masses to be, you know, a top 10 type opponent that you really could hang your hat on, that you would believe in, but also that the public would believe in, was a good opponent that you had defeated before you fought for the heavyweight title?
Well, you know, as I came into boxing, you know, we already had a plan. We had a goal to what we wanted to do. And I think my team done a damn great job of bringing me along in my career. I got one of the best teams in the world, you know, with my whole team combined together. So, you know, who they lined up for me, you know, is who they lined. I've done my job each and every time. You know, I don't care who the opponent was, who it was. You know, I done learned a lot throughout these years, and that's what it's all about. It's about learning, you know, and going forward with that. You know, I understand that people see that, you know, when I got in the ring, I done knocked people out and stuff. But that stuff not easy, man, at all. It's not easy. Sometimes I sit back and like, wow, another knockout. You know, of course, it's been many times that I wanted a certain type of fighter or this, but it didn't fall through. But, you know, anything that I can't control, I don't worry about. I don't let it stress me out knowing that my time, my opportunity is coming. And that was just my time and my opportunity. You know, as many fighters that I've fought and say, okay, now Wilder, you know, we about to get his test. We about to see what he's going to do. But then
when it's time to fight and I go in and do the impossible or the unbelievable, they tend to turn that, oh, he was a bum or this and that. That's why I say with this fight, I don't want nobody to make excuses for me. Once I go in and do what I'm supposed to do, I know what I got to do and do it in the fashion that I know I'm gonna do it in. I don't want people to discredit me. I've been discredited so long, which is fine because I don't listen to all that. You know, everybody loves a winner. I'm successful. My family blessed. I'm blessed. So everybody loves a winner. I don't care much about what they say, but you know, now it's a time where it's come where it's say, hey, enough is enough. Man, that dude, he got to be just that good. You know, and, you know, throughout my career, people have been saying this and this and turning their back. You know, you brought up the Malik Scott. A lot of people was going against me because Malik, I still consider now, is one of the most technical fighters in boxing. You know, I've been in a lot of great camps with him. I've seen a lot of things that he's done, he can do inside and outside of the ring. A lot of people had that fight more towards him than I. But when I went in there and did what I did, it's like they changed. You know, even some of his fellow guys that he used to hang out with or he was raised from, they turned their back on him when they was against him at first, but then when he lost, they went against him. You know, they was with him at first, but then when he lost, they went against him. So, you know, I just want all my credit. Once, you know, here he comes again, another opponent that can be credible, you know, a world champion. And now, you know, it's a 50-50 fight. People like this fight. People are excited about this fight. They are super excited about this fight, you know. And I'm happy for that. I'm happy for the heavyweight division and it is to bring that movement, that momentum back. So now I want people to stay excited and I want them to stick with their word. If they for him, stay for him. They for me, stay for me. Don't switch up when the outcome now don't go your way. That's just all I'm saying.
Yeah, Deontay, I think it's human nature for everybody to look at a new guy that comes along and compare him to somebody and who does he remind him of. Not so terribly long ago, there was a guy who was about your size, got everybody excited, had a background as being an athlete in other sports, and then he ran into Lennox Lewis and got exposed a little bit. How familiar are you with a guy named Michael Grant? And when you hear, when anybody says, well, you know, he might be the same kind of guy that, you know, he'll get exposed a little bit when he runs into a tougher opponent. How do you feel about that? I mean, do you see any parallels between yourself, possible parallels between yourself and Michael Grant?
Not at all. You know, I don't feel no type of way. You know, I don't even like people to compare me to, even if he was the greatest fighter in the world. You know, Richard Schaefer was considered one of the hardest hitting heavyweights in history. But, I don't want to be, you know, it ain't going to do me no justice to say, oh, I have a style of here, I compare them. That ain't doing me no good. When I get inside the ring, that ain't nothing. What Michael Grant done, that was his legacy, that was his journey. My name is Deontay LeSean Wilder. Nice to meet you guys. If you didn't know, that's my name. What he have done, that's what he done. My path, my journey, what God had for me is a whole totally different thing than what Michael Grant had going for himself. You know, I don't care what he's done. I'm on a totally different path. You know, everybody can have the same destiny, have the same glory, you know. This is my time. This is me. You know, when people, you know, compare me to other people, I like the compliments, whether it's good and bad, but I don't want them because I'm making my own legacy. I'm building my own thing. I'm building my own foundation. I'm Deontay Wilder, baby. Nice to meet you.
Don, are you there?
Yeah.
Can you and or Steven Espinoza, Steven's on the phone, address why the negotiations took so long, and particularly from your standpoint, what was it like negotiating with Al Haymon?
I think it's boxing. What you take long, you know, the fruit of the fruit of your labor is what you got right now, Lim. You got the heavyweight championship fight, and I say this fight for peace symbolizes the essence of America's creed: freedom, justice, equality, liberty, and peace, which makes all Americans proud and extremely grateful. This is what I'm looking for. You know, bringing the heavyweight championship back to America, we're doing that. You know what I mean? It's just as I said when he beat Areola. You know what I mean? So now we got an opportunity here now to demonstrate what boxing really is. As the heavyweights go, so goes boxing. everything has been in more of a downward cycle than rather than an upward cycle in boxing. That's where all of the deals and everything else have changed. You know what I mean? Now we got to get the groundswell of public opinion, the support, you know, from the lumping proletariat. Everyone, when they go out, when is the next one? That's got to be the battle cry, because it's so exciting, so provocatively beautiful in what we're trying to do. I love Al Haymon. I think he's a great guy. I love Espinoza. As I said, Les Moonves, it was ingenious to get a guy to get the support to this guy who now they criticize and weigh this, that, and the other. But Showtime is moving to the forefront. It's moving to the forefront methodically, calculatedly, and systematically to bring boxing back to the people. And that's what it's really all about, the people. So I'm happy, man. It ain't took a long time. It's a short time, man. It's a time that, hey, in the twinkling of an eye, you're going to see the baddest heavyweight match in history coming up January 17th, Martin Luther King's birthday, Ali's birthday, all in the same month. Is going to be sensational, Lim. Let the world know. Call friend and foe alike and let them know what Ring Magazine, the Bible of Boxing, is talking about. Excuse me. Man, go to work, man. Hey, go to work. This is great. I'm so excited, Lim. I know you're going to carry the word to that friend and foe. Okay. Let them know what time it is. It's heavyweight time. What is it? America's time. Bringing that old glory. A return to glory.
Phil said it best. There's a lot of parties involved, and it's a big fight. It's a big event. I know that now that it's been announced, you talk about the support from Haiti. We've heard from a number of other pro athletes, NFL and otherwise, you know, of Haitian descent, have already asked for tickets. It's been quite a while that I've seen the kind of immediate ticket demand over the last few days that we've seen, other than a Mayweather fight. That's the only thing I can really compare it to. So the heavyweights are definitely back, and people are happy to hear that.
Okay, I did want to ask Don one more time. What was it like dealing with Al Haymon, business standpoint? You being a businessman in the past, kind of one of the predecessors, what was it like dealing with him directly for this big fight?
You know, Lamb, you got to think back. This is the 40th anniversary of the Rumble in the Jungle, Muhammad Ali and George Foreman. You have to think of everything that we had to come through. Talking to Al Haymon, a brilliant, intelligent young man, is something that it's really great, you know, for me to see. Because at the time, you're talking about difficulties, and still difficulties would be back then, when you got to go to country to country to country looking for a site because you couldn't even put it on in America. You know what I mean? So you got to be able to understand what is real and what is practical. You know what I mean? With the height of segregation and racism and everything there, they wouldn't be out water to cry with. You know what I mean? So now I end up in Kinshasa, Zaire, and it's become legendary in its history. You know what I mean? There's the 40th anniversary of the Rumble in the Jungle from then to now, with the heavyweight champion going into the ring again, you know what I mean, to carry on to more exposure and how to make things happen in this great country called America. So therefore, it is Al Haymon is icing on the cake. He's a treat. It's like having a glorious dinner, you know what I mean, to be able to have everything, the hors d'oeuvres, the wine, whatever you're going to have, and to have their main course. So, I mean, it's nothing. I think Al Haymon is great. So the idea is to just deal with what is real and what is practical, because this is the 40th anniversary. All this is going to inure to the benefit of this title fight. I'm talking to Imelda Marcos about 2 months ago. You know what I mean? I'm going to invite her to the fight from the Thriller in Manila, because it becomes the 40th anniversary of the Thriller in Manila. You know what I mean? And she said, well, you know, you put Manila on the map. You know what I mean? Thank you so very much for your kind words, Imelda. But this is about what life is. This is the struggle of life, and the reward is in the journey. So I'm so happy that I have an opportunity to meet and greet and to be able to discuss something with a guy like Al Haymon, a guy like Stephen Espinoza, you know what I mean, a guy like Richard Stern. And but you think back at it and think about Kirk Kerkorian, who I'm paying a tribute to and salute in this program. You know, it's something one of the founders, one of the guys who opened the door, you know what I mean? And him and I were friends on it. He's 96 years old right now. So these are the things I'm looking at. I'm looking at yesterday, today, and tomorrow. That is my theme, you know what I mean? And so we're going to be able to be practical and make things happen. So it's a piece of cake, Lim, a piece of cake. So let's go out there and try to change things for the betterment of the greatest nation in the world, make things better in America and around the world. That's why I symbolize that freedom, justice, liberty, and equality in all of my promotions now, because that's what means something to me and to the people of this great nation. So everything was good.
Don King, a quick follow-up, if you will, please. I'm curious, how exactly is this fight going to bring, you referenced earlier, world peace to the planet? What's the tie-in between this fight and world peace?
Well, the tie-in between this fight and world peace is a prevention rather than cure. You know what I mean? We had a war where we lost like 60 million people or 67 million people in the Second World War. You understand? I mean, it's little discussion, communication, inclusiveness, respect of culture, and fighting has been like the catalyst to bring people together, you know what I mean, to be able to understand humanity and human beings. And so when you can bring people to the world leaders that we will invite, and hopefully they can be able to make it, but if we go to their different countries and have fights, which I plan to do when Bermane continues to reign, you know what I mean, and demonstrates how the talent that he has and beating a young, gifted young man like Deontay Wilder, I want to take him all around from all of the Middle East and Egypt and all of the different places, you know, just as I did with Ali and Zaire, you know, and George Foreman. So it's a thing here that is a thing where you have opened up a line of communication, you know what I mean, something that you can be able to deal with, you know what I mean, the give and take situation, you know what I mean, so peace with everyone would be able to do. You can't have a one side. It can't be it's my way or the highway. You know what I mean? So we can open up things where you all find out that would be descriptive of what what Shakespeare said in the Shylock, the Merchant of Venice. You know what I mean? Don't I have eyes? I'm a Jew. Do I have eyes? You know, can I hear? Can I see? Could I do? I get hurt? If you prick me, do I laugh? If you pick me, do I bleed? You know, if you tickle me, do I laugh? I mean, it's the same thing. People basically are human beings. And so, therefore, if we can find that with that common denominator and not miscalculate and say, I did say it that way, I thought it was this way, sit down and talk to one another. So peace is embryonic, you know what I mean? If we can be able to make this thing happen. And so I make my fights for peace, and it goes for world peace and for national peace. You know, like you can see things that happen now from a way of life that is being transpired in our great nation called America. I mean, so it's a tragedy. I mean, to come up with no indictments, no bills, no nothing on people getting killed with their hands up, being choked to death, laying on the sidewalk. Everything you got to understand, it has to be able to be talked out and enlightened. You know, because it's deeply rooted in American psyche. You know what I mean? Non-inclusive, inferior, woman, and people of color. So you got to be able to discuss this in a manner where you can enlighten, to teach, to bring together education and make things happen for the betterment of our country. That's what we're fighting for now, and that's what Bermane is going to become, the people's champion, fighting for peace, bringing the which means understanding and putting in quotes those freedom and justice, equality and liberty, America's creed, what it was born in, what we forgot. We boast the self-evident truth, but we live and practice the self-evident lie. Let us change that. And through bringing people together, all walks of life, we got an opportunity to do so. So let's make this fight for peace a great one.
Deontay, then, what is your assessment of Bermane's punching power?
I really don't know. I mean, the guy got some credible knockouts on his resume, but you know, like he said before, I mean, January 17th, don't bleed. You know, he said it perfectly. You know, so we'll find out. I'm looking forward to finding out. I'm looking forward to answering a lot of questions that's been about me. You know, some will be answered, some will be not. So we'll see. So, like he said before, I'm gonna re-quote him: January 17th, don't blink.
Could you tell us how you view this fight in terms of its significance for the whole heavyweight division?
Man, I honestly think this is the most anticipated, most exciting, most powerful heavyweight bout in a very long time, man. And not only just going off of my own feelings, but just going off the energy that's around me, even in my city. You know, I'm from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, and this is a football state, man. This is the football, but, you know, over my years of what I've done, being in the Olympics and still gaining my success as a that's coming up in the heavyweight division and being undefeated and now getting my opportunity to fight for world title. You know, even the people around here is grabbed host to the heavyweight division. I've had people that never watched boxing before in their life, but they read about my stuff and they kept up with me, and they all tuned. A lot of people's going to be there. That's all. This is a big talk about. You know, we got football going on. They're going to get ready to win another national championship, but yet alone, they're still talking about boxing as well, too. So it's exciting times, man. That right there alone, you know, just tell me, man, how significant this bout, how good, how great this match, this what a matchup it is, and how great it's gonna be. You know, I'm super excited just to be a part of it, just the movement of the heavyweight division, and just bringing it back. My name can be on there when the words go out, the heavyweight division is back, and I can say I was a part of that movement along with a lot of other people. So I'm just happy. I'm excited, man. My heart is warm and filled with joy, man. And what a great to spend time with family through these holidays and come around the next year and to shock the world. Like Muhammad Ali once said, I shocked the world. Now I get an opportunity to shock the world as well, too, man. So I'm excited. I cannot wait, man. This is great.